on the toilet door. Anybody inside? It really looks like Friday. Actually, tomorrow is Friday.
Can we film you doing this one? It's not really... Are we going to have a proper...
Since I've been an entrepreneur for about 15, 16 years or more, you know, people thought that I do this trade and, you know, I should be doing this trade lah. Why go into any other trade? But the thing is, when I think that I cannot break through, because any entrepreneur, right, will go through this journey of asking themselves, you know, I'm doing well now, and thus what will I be? Where will I take my business?
Right.
You know? And then the worst thing is you come back from the course, don't say no breakthrough. Sometimes totally get more confused.
Oh yeah, yes.
You know, right?
Yeah.
And then you go back to the office, and then you look at the blank wall, you just feel like knocking your head against the blank wall. It's like, and then you go, you know, when I was in Ang Mo Kio, I will go coffee shop, talk to the ape. Ape also looking for breakthrough. Oh my god, I'm here trying to find breakthrough by talking to, you know, people who have been doing business 30 years, 20 years earlier than me. They also looking for breakthroughs.
Yeah.
What jialat leh. And then when I talk to the younger guys, you know, like those who do digital marketing business lah, all these. Bitcoin, blockchain. I'm also confused because I cannot understand. It's like, oh my god, where have I been the past 15, 16 years? Why have I not been able to understand what technology is this, what blockchain, what? Hey, really, really, and can affect you lah, your mental health. I see, of course, my good friend Khee is talking about Crave. Wow, suddenly we're talking about nasi lemak. So Crave, from where, Khee? From where you found this Crave? Adam, is it? Adam Road?
No.
Where? Bedok.
No, Crave, I started eating when it was in Plaza Singapura.
Okay.
I tried. So I found that the rice is quite nice. And then I found that it's quite clean and, like, you know, like, it's a shopping center, you know, like, it's not the the air condition uncomfortable. I just want a meal. So I first found Crave initially there. Then after that I went to Bedok Interchange. Bedok Mall. And then I saw Crave again. So I was quite interested to know. And then I read about the history, about it started from Adam Hawker Center.
So you fell in love with the story lah?
I think I was interested. I mostly fell in love. I like to read the history, where it comes from.
Yeah, you tell me something. I'm learning something from you. And I hope the audience here learns.
I'm good. I'm
and then tell your story.
Yeah, you tell a story. It started from one man show or whatever. They started to serve the community around there. Then suddenly there's a lot of people going there to eat. Then they started to expand, you know, something like that. And then, from a humble beginning, you know, from a family business, then now they are trying to reinvent. Right? Is that the word?
Yeah, you can say that.
Reinvent of the concept of nasi lemak to bring it to the world.
Now, my question as an entrepreneur is, how did Crave reinvent? And, you know, I believe we can call Crave successful in rebranding.
Yes, rebranding,
so
yes.
How?
I think firstly,